Madiokolo district officials handed over the sites to contractors to commence work in May 2022, with works expected to be completed in a period of 9 months. But to date, 7 of the projects have not been completed, with only 1 delivered. Out of the 8 project sites, 5 have stalled, with the leaders expressing worry over the failure by the contractor to complete the works. The first contract periods expired, but an extension has been given to the end of April 2024. Drabe is optimistic 2 more resource centers will be completed, but expressed worry over the football ground where the contractor has abandoned site.
We received 8 projects under estimate. This included 5 resource centers, 2 markets, and 1 football pitch. As a district, we have tried our level best to pay certificates on time. But most of these contractors, they are performing below the standards required of a giant contractor.
The contractors undertaking the works include Sima Construction Company for the construction of a resource center in Rigbo sub-county at shillings 846 million. Shillings 1 billion Matangatia market was handed over to Rina One Investment Limited. The construction of a bomber ground opposite the district headquarters is undertaken by Geomax Engineering Limited at shillings 1 billion, but this project has stalled and contractor has abandoned the site. Other contractors are KG Adubango Construction Company for Ayavu Modern Market in their town council, worth shillings 1.4 billion. Zimu Construction Company undertaking construction of a community center worth shillings 800 million, which work has not been completed.
The contractors have abandoned sites, but of late we have compelled some of them to subcontract their works. The resource center at Rigbo has been subcontracted. This time we are seeing an improvement. There is a speed in the work being done. Then this one of the town council has also been subcontracted, and the subcontractors have gained momentum and they are pushing on well.
Joanne Aniku Okia, the woman member of parliament for Madiokolo district, warns contractors to desist from hiding in the names of the first family when they have failed in implementation of projects. This is after the RDC Swipe Toko said some of the contractors claim they are connected to the first family and use it to threaten the leaders who make inquiries on delayed projects.
I think for me it's very simple. If it's proven that they received the money and they have not done the work, then they should face the consequences of that. Last time anti-corruption unit was here arresting people, you saw people being arrested in Arua. I wish that if those people had been put to the book, I wish those people had been put to the book.
So I'm sorry to say this. A lot of money has been put in this. Just where you've seen the level where it is, and a lot of money has been put there, more than 1 billion has been what invested there, but there's nothing on the ground. When you go there, even to a layman like me who cannot explain much, but you just know that nothing much has taken place, or is going on here.
Swipe Toko, the RDC Madiokolo, advises for termination of the contract of contractors whose work have not reached 70% and such projects be subcontracted to new contractors to complete the work.
My humble advice is all contractors who have not gone beyond 70%, their contracts will not be renewed. This project should be given to new contractors.
Madiokolo district is benefiting from USMID projects for hosting refugees. Report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news.